Can the Hawkapellas please come up for the singing of the national anthem?
Red glare, the bombs bursting in air. Yeah. Good evening. Hope everybody can hear me okay. It's my pleasure to welcome you out, the 54th Gibault Catholic High School commencement. Did you wonder if this was going to happen or not? I think all of us have been trying to figure out how and when and where. We originally were set for May 18th. And as things would have it, we had to move it to June 8th. And then again to July 1st. I just want to tell you how happy I am. I told a lot of you, we're going to have it. Just hang with me. We're going to figure it out and figure out how to do it. It's a little different than what they've done in the past, but we're here and I'm very, very happy about that. As many of you know, this was my first year as a principal at Gibault High. Am I okay? There we go. The year started out rather interesting as I was, my first day at Gibault was on August 1st. So as you can say, I hit the ground running. And right into February, where we ran into something that's never happened before in the history of schools. And I just want to say I'm really proud and happy how everyone handled it at Gibault High School, the teachers, the students. It's easy to say that it wasn't fair and, you know, use a lot of excuses, but you guys did what you had to and got through it, and I'm really proud of all of you. As the year went on, I had a chance to get to know a lot of you for very many different reasons. Being the first year and your last year, I'm proud to say that I think I learned almost all of your names. I did my best. I had a lot to learn this year, but I'm really excited to see where you're going from here. I know when we looked at the $3,500,000 worth of scholarships that were offered to you guys, that says a lot about this class. So I just want to tell you, thanks for being my first class, for being a part of a very interesting year, and I wish you nothing but the best as you move forward. So at this time, we're going to open with a prayer, and I'm going to invite the senior class president, Jeremy Beckner, to come forward.
All right, good evening, everybody. I believe the class is reciting this with me, so I'll just go ahead and start. Dear God, tonight we stand beside you. It has only been through your grace that we have made it here, and we will not forget that. We will move onwards in our lives, we will grow, and sadly, we may lose touch with each other. But we will not forget what you have done for us through Gibault Catholic High School. Solely because of you, we can thank our classmates for friendship and all of its accompanying virtues. We may thank each other for all the laughter and life lessons we've accumulated throughout our 4 years here, but we must not forget to thank you. And it is because of you that we can thank our teachers, coaches, and all the members of the faculty. You've blessed us with such great mentors. We thank them for all of the books we've read together, games we've played together, and the morality bestowed on us. And for that, we thank you. As we move forward with our diplomas in hand, we look to you, God the Father. We thank you with all of our hearts for letting us into the Gibault family with open arms. It has been both a privilege and an honor to walk beside you at Gibault. Our love grew stronger with each and every day. Thank you, Lord, for blessing the class of 2020 with our great faith in you. We make our prayer through Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
At this time, I'm going to invite Scott Ruppel to come forward and present the Spirit of Gibault, Father Gibault Award.
Good evening. As campus minister and on behalf of the Gibault Catholic High School community, it is an honor and a privilege to present the Spirit of Father Gibault Award each year to the most deserving young man and young woman. Father Pierre Gibault, the school's namesake, lived in this area around the time of the Revolutionary War and has been described as the Patriot Priest. By definition, a patriot is one who loves, supports, and defends his or her country and its interests with passionate devotion. Besides his sense of patriotism, Father Gibault clearly demonstrated his passionate love and devotion to the Lord Jesus through his ordained ministry and the life he lived. It was these qualities that inspired the founder of our school, Father Ed Hustedy, to name it after Father Gibault. The young man and young woman who received the Spirit of Father Gibault Award embody the ideals of both Father Gibault and Father Ed, and model qualities that every student at Gibault should strive to possess: a passionate love of God, strong Catholic Christian values, and a desire to be of service. The individual possesses a positive attitude, shows kindness, consideration, and common courtesy toward all, and is keenly aware of the needs and situations of others. These individuals strive for the best in themselves, to elicit good from others, and to lead by example. The recipients of this award are voted on each year by the administration, faculty, and staff. Mr. Eric Schrader and Ms. Ashlyn Whiteman, I'm so happy to tell you that this year we have selected you as the most deserving recipients of the Spirit of Father Gibault Award. Congratulations to you both. Please come forward to be recognized. Please show your appreciation. Give a hand to Eric Schrader and Ashlyn White.
Just kind of a little detail for you. When we are done today, Ms. Tapin and Ms. Groman will be at the front of school, and they will have your awards, and I'd like for the seniors to pick those up before they leave today, okay? At this time, I am proud to present our valedictorians and our salutatorian. So when I say your name, please stand up. Our valedictorians for this year are Spencer Bisk, Josh Eicholtz, Hannah Gunlach, Kelly Pappenberg, and our salutatorian, Kayla Hewels. How about a big hand for them? At this time, I'm going to invite each of our valedictorians to come up and give a address. So we'll begin with Spencer Bisk.
Good evening, Mr. Kidd, faculty and staff, family, friends, and fellow graduates. I'm proud to be able to speak on behalf of this class. Obviously, this is certainly not the situation that we wanted to or expected to be graduating in. We never expected our senior year to be cut short. We still had so many things left to accomplish. We never got our last state appearances. We never got our final performance or show. We didn't even get the chance to walk through the halls one last time as students. But that is not what we'll be remembered for. This is a class with many, many state appearances in athletics and academics. This is a class that succeeded in everything we set out to do, even when the odds were stacked against us. Most importantly, this is a class of faith. Some of these students spent an entire weekend in Indianapolis to celebrate that. Others went to Cairo, Illinois to help the less fortunate. Some even created and ran an entire retreat for younger Catholics. Each and every one of us went out into the world for 3 weeks with only one goal in mind, to help others. The current situation in the world does not define this class. I think the soccer team's motto from our junior year perfectly sums up the impact of this situation. We decide our legacy. This class will not be remembered by what we lost. We will not be remembered by these tragedies that we've suffered. We've written our own history. We will be remembered by our championships. We will be remembered by the energy and the life that we brought to the school. We will be remembered by our faith. I think our faith is the most important quality to have during these difficult times. Our class has proven time and time again that our trust in God will not fail. In this world plagued by the bad, this class, along with all graduating classes this year, is a shining star of hope for the future. During these times, it's important for us to look forwards. We will go off to college and continue our education. We'll be teachers, lawyers, and doctors. We will not give up on our own future. God has a plan for each and every one of us. Now, I'll keep this short since there are four of us speaking, but I want to take some time to thank those of you who have helped us along the way. Thank you to our teachers for helping us get through these 4 years and for helping us to actually learn something. Thank you to all of the Gibault staff for keeping this wonderful school running smoothly. Thank you to all of our coaches for helping us find our passions. Thank you to our priests and religious leaders that have helped us understand the Lord's plan for us. Thank you to all of our parents and family members who have supported us and helped us with everything along the way. Most importantly, thank you to all of my classmates for making these past 4 years some of the best of our lives. I wish each and every one of you the best of luck as we continue to live out God's plan.
Okay, next I want to invite Josh Eichholz to come up.
Mr. Kidd, faculty members, family, friends, and fellow graduates, although it can be easy to get lost in the bad news of the current world, today is a day to be thankful and to be inspired. I'm sure none of us had 2020 vision for what this year would hold for us, but I hope we can all have perfect sight while looking back at the gifts we have. We have much to be thankful for. Here at Gibault, we have received a great education thanks to our wonderful teachers and unique methods of operation. All of us are prepared to move on and to take on whatever challenges face us in our lives. Fellow graduates, I want you all to know what a great gift it is to be as prepared as we are, because not all schools offer such an advantage. Here we have had a high degree of academic excellence and preparation for the world, and in further education and in other parts of our lives, we will benefit from what we have learned here. From technological skills learned to computer apps, to the poems of English class, to the life lessons taught to us in religion and other classes, everything we have learned has the potential to help us throughout our lives. We also must be thankful for our families. These past 4 years have presented us with a lot of ups and downs, and it is good to know that we had our families in our corner, supporting us along the way. It has often taken a lot of sacrifice from our parents to give us the opportunities we have had at Gibault, but they have provided this for us. Thanks, Mom and Dad. I would not be here today without you. All of us should be thankful for each other. The friendships that we have made here will last a lifetime. In the same way we have supported each other and helped each other succeed in these years at Gibault, I hope we will continue to provide support and encouragement for each other in all future endeavors. Finally, we should always be thankful to God for all He has done for us. He has brought us all here and keeps all of us together in His love, even in these times of social distancing and physical separation. If we treat each other with at least a shadow of the love God has for us, the world will become brighter and brighter. Although the world can be a scary place, we will get by within it, so long as we do not lose sight of who we are now and who we can be in the future if we just work on ourselves. I look at all of us, and I see how much we have all grown and developed these past 4 years. I think all of us could say that we have improved in at least one area of our lives during our time here at Gibault. If we keep this personal improvement going throughout our lives with God's help, we will eventually become the best people we can possibly be, and then what will be able to stop us? When you leave here today, celebrate what you have accomplished and how far you have come, but look to the future while thinking about how you can improve and how you can be an inspiration for others. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Next speech, I want to invite Hannah Gunlach to come forward.
Good evening, Mr. Kidd, the faculty and staff of Gibault, parents, families, and fellow graduates. Thank you for your support and for being here tonight, though not all in person. We can feel love and encouragement from each of you. I also wish to thank you for the opportunity to stand here as a valedictorian. Though our senior year did not go exactly as expected, our class had an excellent 4 years. I am so thankful that each and every one of us had that last opportunity to serve during senior service. I am proud of how these projects changed us. Many of us lacked confidence, and after the opportunity, all could speak to multiple things we learned and the connections made with children, the elderly, and the community. We may have also learned that while we are incredibly skilled in areas that we already knew of, we cannot be talented at everything. My senior service project taught me that I am not the greatest at sixth grade math, but I learned an invaluable lesson that I can work very well with children. Although our first day back from senior service was our last day of school, the conversations I had with many of you about senior service suggest the same and will stay with me for my life. Our memories extend beyond senior service, however. Our class started new traditions at Fall Festival. For example, integrating music circles and hammocks, which gave us more options to come together as a class in new ways. In fact, our support for one another is what I wish to highlight the most. I will always remember when, at our senior retreat, we could not physically support our girls' volleyball team at their match. Instead, though, we became super fans and cheered on our girls' volleyball team from the retreat as we watched them compete over a live stream. In fact, we had impressive state runs in multiple sports over the course of our 4 years, all backed by the enthusiastic support of our fan section. We cheered each other on in competitions like Academic Challenge and supported each other's talents in art, music, and theater. We created clubs like Stomp Out Suicide and Young Women Professionals that will continue at Gibault for many years to come. Most importantly, through all these activities, we found new ways to connect over common interests. We are so skilled and talented. But these skills and talents mean we are now taking different paths after we graduate. I hope that we will keep our memories with us wherever we go next, and that we will look back on our time at Gibault Catholic fondly. I also hope that we continue to connect over these memories and make new ones together as we move forward in our lives. As the wise Ferris Bueller once said, life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it. These 4 years went by very fast, and it's easy to remember only the last few months instead of all the moments we shared as a class. In the last few months, I've thought a lot about my memories with you all over the last 4 years, and I hope you've had a moment to do the same. Again, I would like to thank all of the teachers, family members, and friends that helped us graduate today. Congratulations to the class of 2020. We did it.
Kelly Pappenberg.
Good evening, Principal Kidd, faculty and staff, parents, and fellow graduates. My name is Kelly Pappenberg, and I am honored to represent the class of 2020 as one of four valedictorians. I would first like to thank all of our past teachers for all the hard work they put in over the years to ensure we received a quality education and for the positive impact they had on us. I want to express our gratitude to all the teachers, administrators, and coaches who have been committed to continuing our education, holding out hope for sports seasons, the spring musical, and all the end of year events, and exploring every option to make the last few months of our senior year feel special. We all appreciate the effort our Gibault family and the City of Waterloo has put into acknowledging our achievement. You have all certainly gone above and beyond, and for that we are thankful. Our reasons for coming to Gibault were all different. For some, it was to continue a family tradition, and for others, it was to start a family tradition. It may have been for the Catholic education or the small school environment. It may have even been your own choice. For whatever reason, and for however long, God brought us all here together, and together we were able to accomplish great things. I personally wish to thank the international students for sharing their cultures with us and enriching our high school experience. You are one of the many reasons we are such a diverse and well-rounded class. We will certainly miss you. As we all go out into the world with our unique gifts and talents leading us in all different directions, let us never forget we will always be a part of the Gibault family. Our time spent at Gibault is the one thing we all share. And whether it was sports, academics, music, theater, or art, we did it, and did it all so well. Our years of Catholic education may be behind us, but Gibault will always be a part of us. After all, our class picture will forever hang in the hall. So, what does our future hold? Don't you wish you could look into a crystal ball and know exactly where life is going to take you? To make sure you make the right decisions, make friends with the right people, and feel satisfied every day. In reality, there's no crystal ball or instruction manual. Every decision is yours from now on. To quote Martin Luther King Jr., intelligence plus character. That is the goal of true education. Use what you've learned from school and life to be proud of the choices you will make. Trust God and yourselves that you are on the right path. Overall, be proud of yourself and your accomplishments. Keep a special place in your heart for all of your fellow classmates. Give a hug, send a text, keep in touch. You never know when you will see each other again. While our senior year was not traditional, it certainly was memorable. I always knew this class would make history, but who would have imagined how? We have proven our ability to face unprecedented challenges as no class has ever had to before. I choose not to dwell on what was taken from us, but rather what we were given over the past 4 years. Always remember, our story is a great one, but it doesn't end here. In closing, I would like to share a Bible quote, Timothy chapter 4, verse 12. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for believers in speech, in life, in love, in faith, and in purity. Congratulations, graduates. Until we meet again, thank you.
Microphone. It doesn't.
I want to introduce you.
Am I too close? Is that the problem? All right, we'll try again. I want to introduce you to the newest part of our uniform that we're adding next year. You'll be the first class that didn't have that. At this time, I want to invite Ms. Haley Kaborik to come forward as we present diplomas to all the students.
Families, as I announce your graduate's name, please stand. Kyle Austin Barber, son of Charles and Nicole Barber of Swansea, St. Augustine of Canterbury Parish, Belleville, plans to attend University of Alabama, majoring in aerospace engineering. Eston Scott Bauer, son of Carl and Stacy Bauer of Smithton, Hope Christian Church, plans to attend Western Kentucky University, majoring in environmental science. Jeremy Michael Beckner, son of Larry and Melissa Beckner of Millstadt, St. James Parish, plans to attend Rockhurst University, majoring in English. Megan Elizabeth Bernal, daughter of Jeffrey and Catherine Bernal of Swansea, Holy Childhood of Jesus Parish, plans to attend Indiana State University, majoring in pre-physical therapy. Mattia Beniamini, son of Barbara Piscina and Andrea Beniamini of Milan, Italy, host parents Christopher and Carol Bassler, plans to attend European University of Madrid, majoring in global sports management. Alexander David Byra, son of David and Christine Byra of Waterloo, Immaculate Conception Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-engineering. Spencer Todd Bisk, son of Todd and Andrea Bisk of Columbia, Immaculate Conception Parish, plans to major in astrophysics.
Way to go, Spencer!
Cole Edward Buckner, son of Kevin and Kim Buckner of Oakville, Missouri, plans to attend Webster University, majoring in exercise science. Madison Marie Donlinger, daughter of Andrew and Debbie Hensler of Smithton, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-social work. Joshua Edward Eicholtz, son of Kenneth and Deborah Eicholtz of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend University of Illinois, majoring in actuarial science. Cassandra Ann Elner, daughter of Shirlene Elner of Redbud and Scott Elner of Highland, St. John the Baptist Parish, plans to attend Maharishi International University, majoring in Ayurveda, Wellness, and Integrative Health. Yu Tao Fei, son of Zhongfeng Fei and Yan Shou of Shanghai, China,
host parent John Lee, plans to attend State University of New York, Stony Brook, majoring in mechanical engineering. Alejandro Emiliano Gomez, son of Benjamin and Alma Gomez of Cahokia, Holy Family Parish, plans to attend University of Illinois, majoring in aerospace engineering. Jacob Francisco Gonzalez, son of Marla Ramos of Belleville and Francisco Gonzalez of Cahokia, Our Lady Queen of Peace Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-psychology. Caleb Nathaniel Groman, son of Paul Groman of Hecker and Laura and Matt Giles of Collinsville, St. Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Missouri State Technical College, majoring in electronics engineering technology. Hannah Catherine Gunlock, daughter of Chris and Michelle Gunlock of Waterloo, St. Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend University of Missouri, majoring in strategic communications. Hallie Marie Hodrick, daughter of Jeffrey and Diane Hodrick of Waterloo, St. Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend South Alabama University, majoring in pre-physical therapy. Jonah Richard Hooser, son of John and Jennifer Hooser of Waterloo and Renee Hooser of Waterloo, St. Michael Parish, plans to attend Southern Illinois University, majoring in business administration. Johanna Marie Hooten, daughter of Jeff and Mary Hooten of Redbud, St. John the Baptist Parish, plans to attend Murray State University, majoring in agricultural science. Po Kai Huang, son of Jun Neng Huang and Qin Chi Yang of New Taipei City, Taiwan, host parent Marina Palmieri, plans to attend Seattle Central College, majoring in computer science. Kayla Marie Hules, daughter of Chris and Kimberly Hules of Waterloo, St. Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Webster University, majoring in elementary education. Kylie Rain Jackson, daughter of Summer Jackson of Waterloo, plans to attend Southern Illinois University Edwardsville, majoring in business administration. Hannah Elizabeth Jansen, daughter of Mike and Kim Jansen of Columbia, Immaculate Conception Parish, plans to attend University of Iowa, majoring in English. Nathan Christopher Jansen, son of Christopher and Marty Jansen of Waterloo, St. Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend University of Colorado Boulder, majoring in ecology and evolutionary biology. Yeah. Hannah Mae Johnson, daughter of Steve and Heather Johnson of Swansea, St. Joseph Parish, plans to attend Aurora University, majoring in political science. Madeline Diane Jones, daughter of Debbie Davenroy and the late Mike Jones of Smithton, St. John the Baptist Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-special education. Megan Elizabeth Killey, daughter of Michael and Devon Killey of Valmire, St. Mary Parish, plans to attend Mississippi State University, majoring in criminal justice. Tia Keely Jai Clyden, daughter of Troy and Nicole Clyden of Tamworth, New South Wales, Australia, host parents Doug and Diane Ramey, future plans to major in criminology. Gavin Gregory Kuntz, son of Chris and Jenny Kuntz of Valmire, St. Mary Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-business. Michael Xavier Kostolak, son of Michael and Elizabeth Kostolak of Millstadt, St. James Parish, plans to attend University of Mississippi, majoring in business administration. Julia Nicole Mannix, daughter of John and Christina Mannix of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend St. Louis University, majoring in business administration. Austin Lee Menard, son of Rodney and Angie Menard of Ruma, St. Patrick Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-business. Alex Edward Merlinbach, son of Don Merlinbach of St. Louis and Sherry Beck of St. Louis, plans to attend Jefferson College. Jacob Allen Mueller, son of Allen and Christine Mueller of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-biology. Joseph Gerald Nestor, son of David and Elizabeth Nestor of Millstadt, St. James Parish, plans to attend Lipscomb University, majoring in criminal justice. Elio Pio de Franco Neto, son of Celio and Leila Patricia Franca of Salvador, Brazil, host parents Jerome and Margaret Devanis, plans to attend Lansing Community College, majoring in pre-engineering. Mitchell Jack Nolan, son of Sheila and the late Robert Nolan of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-business. Min Suk Oh, son of Se-young Oh and Gyeong-hee Kim of Daejeon, South Korea, host parents Rodney and Lisa Clammers, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in aviation pilot training. Connor Michael Olson, son of Mike and Donna Olson of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Bellarmine University, majoring in forestry. Ashley Claire Osterhage, daughter of Todd and Lucy Osterhage of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Illinois State University, majoring in marketing. Joshua Joseph Victor Pappenberg, son of Todd and Kim Pappenberg of Waterloo, St. Augustine of Canterbury Parish, Hecker, plans to attend University of Missouri, majoring in sports business management. Kelly Kathleen Pappenberg, daughter of Brad and Claudia Pappenberg of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Kansas State University, majoring in architecture. Lauren Louise Fegley, daughter of Renee Atkins and Clyde Browning of Soge, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in pre-psychology. Natalie Nicole Polarine, daughter of James and Rosemary Polarine of Millstadt, St. James Parish, plans to attend Southwestern Illinois University, Edwardsville. Jack Davis Range, son of Amy and Douglas Elsie and the late Craig Range of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to enlist in the United States Navy. Thank you. Timothy John Reinholds, son of Mark and Barb Reinholds of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish, plans to attend Quincy University, majoring in criminal justice. Ian Edgar Rios, son of Sherry Long of Cahokia and Gerald Rios of Arnold, Missouri. Eric Thomas Schrader, son of Kevin and Annette Schrader of Hecker, St. Augustine of Canterbury Parish, Hecker. Plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in general studies. Carlos Vital de Oliveira Simoni, son of Paulo and Tatiana Vital Simoni of Salvador, Brazil. Host parent, Summer Jackson. Plans to attend Williams Baptist University, majoring in pre-engineering. William Ryan Simonton, son of Lyle and Jennifer Simonton of Smithton, Saints Peter and Paul Parish. Plans to attend Mississippi State University, majoring in mechanical engineering. Allison Elizabeth Thompson, daughter of Jim and Deb Thompson of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish. Plans to attend Southeast Missouri State University, majoring in health sciences. Anthony James Thompson, son of Jim and Deb Thompson of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish. Plans to attend Southern Illinois University, Edwardsville, majoring in business administration. Anne Marie Thompson, daughter of Jim and Deb Thompson of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish. Plans to attend St. Louis University, majoring in theological studies. Cameron Zane Tenyas, son of Ken and Chris Tenyas of Millstadt, St. James Parish. Plans to attend University of Mississippi, majoring in business administration. Juntin Jo, daughter of Juntin Hua and Jung Ti Le Son of Saigon, Vietnam. Host parents William and Renata Durham. Plans to attend University of South Florida, majoring in biology. Derek Harvey Van Buren, son of Paul and Angela Van Buren of Prairie du Rocher, St. Joseph Parish. Plans to attend Southwestern Illinois College, majoring in general studies. Nicholas Ray Vonderheide, son of Todd and Kimberly Vonderheide of Freeburg, St. Joseph Parish. Plans to attend University of Missouri, majoring in biology. Jia Qi Wang, daughter of Hai Jun Wang and Yan Shi Zhu of Beijing, China. Host parents Todd and Lucy Osterhage. Plans to attend Marquette University, majoring in mathematics. Nicholas Nathan Weilbacher, son of Michael and Robin Weilbacher of Millstadt, St. James Parish. Plans to attend University of Missouri, majoring in agricultural systems management. Ashlyn Olivia Whiteman, daughter of Stephen and Danita Whiteman of Waterloo, Saints Peter and Paul Parish. Plans to attend Illinois College.
Thank you.
Graduates, please stand. Please move your tassels from right to left. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Gibault Catholic High School graduating class of 2020.
All right, go ahead and have a seat for a minute. At this time, I want to invite Ms. Barb Reinholds to come forward. She's been working on this speech for months.
So you get me instead of Bishop Braxton. I wanted to take this opportunity to thank our faculty and staff. This year obviously was not a typical year for them, and we kind of missed Teacher Appreciation Week because we weren't here to celebrate. I'm not good at just talking off the cuff, so I am going to read what I prepared since I did do that, and that way I won't forget anything. It seems like just yesterday that our seniors were walking up these very steps of Gibault for the first time. Mrs. Herzing was making the most of a Kodak moment before each student entered the doors, and Mr. Ruppel was leading the band and welcoming the class of 2020. Happiness, fear, excitement, anxiety, so many emotions. Some of those same emotions you might be feeling today, knowing that in just a few short weeks, you will embark on a whole new world full of adventure. Gibault Catholic High School, a Catholic educational community, celebrates the dignity and uniqueness of every person, cultivates lifelong learning and the pursuit of excellence, fosters faith, inspires commitment to justice and service, and works to develop a life-affirming relationship to the world. This is the mission statement of Gibault, and for over 50 years, the faculty and staff have strived to accomplish this mission with every student who has walked through those doors. In my years of being part of the Gibault family, as with any family, we have experienced many highs, and unfortunately, a few lows. As some of you might know, in March of 2017, Tim's freshman year, I suffered a ruptured brain aneurysm. Something that no one, not even the class of 2020, could see coming. What an amazing family to be part of, as everyone took Tim under their wing. We were abundantly blessed with meals. Lots of meals, rides for Tim, laundry service, and most importantly, prayers. As scary as that time was, I have grown so much stronger in my faith because of it. No matter how strong the storm is stirring, if we trust God, He will get us through. Although your time at Gibault has ended in a way that no one could ever dream possible, I do believe that you will be stronger because of all of this. The book of Proverbs tells us,
Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. This year, the road has been bumpy, to say the least, but you are not the only class to have an unfortunate end to their year. Did you know that on New Year's Eve of 1994, as most people were ringing in the new year, fire destroyed the A building at Gibault? Students returned to complete the school year in portable trailers. The faculty and staff could have called it quits, but our Gibault family, even back then, was dedicated to cultivating lifelong learning and leaning on their faith. How truly blessed we have been to have such a wonderful faculty and staff here at Gibault over the years. It speaks volumes to me that so many of them who attended high school here have returned to carry on this great legacy as teachers and staff. This class of 2020 has seen quite a few changes in their 4 years as a Hawk. Teachers, coaches, even principals have transitioned. As parents, we have entrusted our children to their care. I truly believe that God puts the right people in your life to help you over those bumps on your journey of life. You may not see it now, but someday you will look back on all of this and realize just how God's hand, his divine providence, was at work. In our homes, it takes love to keep a family together. The same goes for our Gibault family. That love was made visible in so many ways this year. Not only did our faculty and staff go above and beyond what was asked of them, but even our alums came to our rescue. We celebrated the uniqueness of each one of you with photos and videos. We cultivated the pursuit of excellence by making our awards ceremony available to everyone online. And what a blessing it was for each of you to complete your senior service projects before the world came to a screeching halt. During our isolation, members of the Gibault Women's Club came to volunteer by weeding and trimming our beautiful campus, of course, while maintaining their social distance. Once the building reopened, the Gibault Men's Club resumed their interior remodels of some of the classrooms, and even our kitchen staff returned to make casseroles to feed those families in our community who were affected by unemployment. And with the help of our maintenance staff, we had not one, but two graduation ceremonies for your class. We are so grateful to all who made the best under these unprecedented times. As you leave Gibault with the same roller coaster of emotions that you entered with 4 years ago, let your faith be stronger than your fears. Continue to grow in your responsibilities to the world and know that God has prepared you for what lies ahead. Leaders don't just lead people to do things. They lead them to do the right things. As you, the class of 2020, is entering so many unknowns, may God continue to bless and guide you on the right path. Spread your wings to fly and have roots deep enough to always call Gibault home.
I'm going to invite Father forward at this time. While he's walking up, I want to ask you all to give a big thank you to Mark and Mary and Kathy, our maintenance staff, who did set up two different graduations. They're sitting over there.
Father, the Son, and the Spirit. Heavenly Father, as we come to the close of this graduation ceremony, may you continue to bless the staff, students, and parents of this great institution. And in a special way for our graduates, may you continue to bless them with hope so that they move into the future with eager and open hearts. Help them to put the skills, knowledge, and insight they have gained in their education in this institution into use for the good of all humankind. Inspire them to believe in the goodness of life, even when faced with challenges and difficulties like this present pandemic. As they commence their lives, may they continue to grow ever more grateful and wise. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the
Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.